Greeting, my Hebrew Israelite brothers and sisters. This is L.D. Smith, the Watchman on the Wall. As always, grab the King James. We always have a fantastic one to bring to mind here. Most of all, tonight, I want you to just think about the things that we're talking about. I mean, just think about the words. Think about what is transpiring in the reading, all right? Now, that being said, first and foremost, my goal is to discredit Jesus, aka Lucifer, or if you want to call him Yeshua. It doesn't matter to me whether you change the name or change the color. It doesn't change the acts that this character here committed, all right? Now, that being said, we're going to be coming from the book of Mark, the 14th chapter. Let us begin at verse 43. It says, "And immediately while he yet spake, cometh Judas, one of the 12, and with him a great multitude with swords and staves from the chief priests and the scribes and the elders." All right, now, what I want you to remember here is a great multitude is coming with Judas here, and they are armed. All right, they came for battle. They came for anything that may pop up. We'll be ready for it. All right. Now, that being said, let us jump down to verse 46. He says, "And they laid their hands on him and took him." All right. Now let's read 48. It says, "And one of them that stood by drew a sword and smote a servant of the high priest and cut off his ear." Now, remember, that was a great multitude that came with Judas. Now here is one that stood there, cut off a servant of the high priest, cut his ear off, all right? Now, we all know that something should be going down by now, right? But watch this right here. It says here in verse 48, "And Jesus answered and said unto them, Are ye come out as against a thief with swords and with staves to take me?" Now, here they are, they're having a conversation. Now, remember now, Jesus' little cronies done cut the servant of the high priest's ear off. Nothing has transpired yet, all right? And look what Jesus says in 49. He said, "I was daily with you in the temple teaching, and ye took me not, but the scriptures must be fulfilled. And they all forsook him and fled." Talking about Jesus' little cronies. Now think about this right here. You know, if the police came to arrest a gang member, say the leader, and one of the gang members shot one of the police's, it's going to be all out hell. It's going to be some gunfire erupt. There's going to be an altercation. There's going to be many killed, if not all of them killed. But here, you see nothing. I mean, this is so out of character. Why in the hell is there not an altercation? Now, but Jesus give this conversation to them, and then his little cronies, they flee. But it even get even better. Let's move on down. Now look at 51. It says, "And there followed him a certain young man, having a linen cloth cast about his naked body." Did y'all hear that? I said, did y'all hear that? It says Jesus was out there in the bushes with a young boy. And the boy was butt-ass naked. Now, to make things right, it says the boy had a linen cloth about his naked body. My question to you preachers is, where are the boy clothes? Y'all ask your pastor, where is this little young boy clothes? Now, my thing to all y'all Yeshua lovers and Jesus lovers, which is why if you change the name, it doesn't change the act that he committed here. I want to know where is this young man clothes? Y'all want to play a little Family Feud? What would be the number one answer? Was they having sex with the boy? Or was the boy posing to take a picture? Or was he out there swimming? The scripture doesn't mention any water, no cameras. So ain't nothing left. The number one answer is they had to be out there having them, having this young boy? Why would the boy have the sheet that he was laying on the ground with draped across his naked body? I mean, if y'all can't see that, something is wrong with y'all mind. The white man has said it for many, many years, saying that the black people, something is wrong with their brain. And I'm believing that. I mean, if you can't see that, here he is out there in the bushes with this little young boy, and the boy's butt-ass naked. That's my question. Now, all y'all Jesus lovers and Yeshua lovers, I tell you what, if you caught your pastor out there at the park with your 13-year-old son, what would you do? What would you do if you caught him out there with your 13-year-old son and your son didn't have any clothes on? The only thing that he had draped across his body was the blanket that he was laying on. What would you do? Would you still love him? Would you still love your pastor if you caught your pastor out there with your 13-year-old son? That's what I'm asking you. Because Jesus was caught out there with this little young boy. And the reason why I know he loved him when they're young, because in Matthew, the 19th chapter, he said, suffer little children to come unto me. So my thing is this, between a little one and a young man, probably 9, 10 years old, up until maybe 14 or 15 years old. Now, somewhere in that range, why can't you ask your pastor? You give him your damn tithes every Sunday. Now, by you paying him, you should be able to demand an answer. You ask him, where is the child clothes? And another thing too, there is called a secret book of Mark that they didn't publish in the Bible, and it talks about Jesus, aka Lucifer, staying with a young boy all night long. Did you hear what I said? I said in the secret books of Mark that they didn't publish. You can probably Google it. Try. But anyway, he was with a young boy all night long, and they wouldn't publish it because they thought that it would be offensive to the Christian community. Huh? Do you like Yeshua now? Do you still love your Jesus? Here he is out there with a teenage boy, and the boy is butt naked. Now, why the boy didn't have no clothes on? Let me tell you why. The element of surprise. Didn't have time to put him on. Now, look what it says here. I know that he was with this little boy because the scripture said that he was falling behind Jesus. Now, if he was with the other 11 that fled, why he didn't follow after them? Why he didn't flee with them? But he was with Jesus. My thing to all you Yeshua lovers and all you Jesus lovers, if any of y'all out there married, if you caught your wife out there with your pastor and she didn't have no drawers on and no bra, and she had a sheet draped about her naked ass body, what would you do? If you didn't solidify that problem right then, if you didn't get that shit straightened out right then, I would call you a jelly spineless, jelly backbone shell of a man. You ain't shit. And I mean that from the bottom of my heart. And the same thing with you Christian women. If you caught your husband or your boyfriend out with a young person and they was butt naked of the opposite sex, and you didn't deal with that shit then, I'll say you ain't worth a damn either. Straight up. I mean, you want it raw? I'm being real with you. Here it is. This damn pedophile is out there in the bushes with somebody, baby. It's right here at the pages. But you know what, though? You fucking Christians, y'all just don't get it. I mean, a person, they can shit on you and piss on you and tell you that it's raining, and you'll believe it. He's putting it right here in your face. Where is the baby clothes? That's my question. Ask your damn pastor. Tell him I said it. Ask him, where is the child clothes? He got a damn a sheet wrapped around his neck and his naked body. Where's his clothes? But y'all don't have enough nuts. You ain't got enough guts to go and ask him these questions that I'm asking you to ask. Go ask him. And you're damn right. I'm very upset with these pastors. You know why? Because they're taking my sisters and brothers' money, feeding them a bunch of bullshit. And this is the only platform that I have. Yes, I'm upset. I'm very much upset. Now look what he says here. In 52, it says, and he left the linen cloth and fled from them naked. He was still following behind Jesus. He was still following behind Jesus, but when they wanted to arrest him too, he fled and left the sheet that he had covering his naked body. Israel, how long are you going to be stupid? How long? How long? I mean, I can go through this New Testament and tear Lucifer, a.k.a. ass all to pieces. I can rip Jesus' ass all up with his own words. And also, y'all want to paint him black? I don't give a damn if y'all paint him blue. It doesn't change the writing and the act that he committed. Oh, well, he's not Jesus now. He's Yeshua and he's black. I don't give a damn. He can be blue. It doesn't change the writings and the acts that he did. After all, the act that he so-called did, he got up on the third day. That's what all y'all hope is in. That's what your salvation is in. The act that he got up. And I proved to you, Easter, I proved to all y'all that, damn it, he did not stay in the earth 3 days and three nights. If you can count Friday evening to early Sunday morning, it's not no damn 3 days and three nights. How long are we going to be so damn stupid? Look, I don't know what else to do. I can't cut your head open and pour it in there. I don't know what else, I don't know what else to do to get you to understand. But I do know one thing. I ain't going to stop. I ain't giving up. I ain't going to stop. Hell no, I ain't stopping. No, I ain't going to stop. I'm going to keep on. I got another one to prove to you that Jesus is a pedophile. He's nothing but a faggot, a homosexual. You can call him. You can change his name to Yeshua. I don't give a damn. You can change his name to a blue. I don't give a damn. He still committed these fucking acts. Ask your pastor, just like I asked you men that are married and men that have boyfriend and girlfriend. If you catch your girlfriend out at the park and she is butt-ass naked with nothing but a sheet wrapped across her ass, what are you going to say? And your grown man, too, that is married, if you caught your wife out there with a little teenager boy and she was butt-ass naked, what would you say? Would you say they was out there praying, speaking in tongues, being a damn jackass? I mean, we are some dumbass people when it comes to thinking. And all I ask you to do is just think. And you still want to run off and search and do all this other bullshit. And the thing about it, I'm not searching for shit. I already know. Y'all have already told me. I ain't got to search out with nobody. Y'all has came and told me and showed me. That's why I keep on sharing this information with you. You read over it every day and never see it. Here he is out there in the bushes with somebody's baby boy. And the boy's butt naked. My question to you, what is he doing out there in the bushes with a little boy? And the boy ain't got no clothes on. And got a sheet that he was laying on, draped across his body. Not covered up. Just thrown across his damn shoulder, probably. Israel, when is he going to wake up? Until next time, shalom.